pessoal, eu sou aqui, que eu tô aqui com Aaron Greenberg, o gerente geral de marketing da marca Xbox. Thank you so much for being here with us, to giving us this interview. And I want to start asking about xCloud. You recently announced it like a few days ago, and I think it was like the only service Microsoft didn't have, because you have a lot. Why bring this kind of service now?
Yeah, I mean, we announced Project xCloud, which basically we're talking about really a commitment and a multi-year vision to deliver cloud streaming and cloud gaming. The opportunity here is to be able to deliver games to people on their mobile phones and their tablets. So if you're an Xbox gamer today and you're playing on your console or you're playing on a PC, you know, when you're not at that device and you're out of the home, how do you stay connected to those games? With cloud streaming and Project xCloud will enable you to do that. The other opportunity is there's just, you know, in Brazil, for example, there's more cell phones than there are people. And so a lot of these people are not going to be able to go buy a dedicated gaming device or a high-end PC, but we want to be able to bring gaming to them as well. So developing that tech so that we can bring it for 4G and eventually 5G, cell phone streaming gaming as well.
And now you have a big array of services, like I was saying. Is there anything else you plan to offer to Microsoft and Xbox users?
Well, the great thing is that, you know, gaming is now like a priority pillar in the company. Phil Spencer works for the CEO of Microsoft. So just there's a lot of, you know, focus and investment in gaming. And so we've been able to, you know, we talked at E3 about how we're continuing to innovate and invest in the console hardware for the future. The same team that built the Xbox One X is thinking about the future of console hardware. You know, an incremental innovative investment is what we're doing in Project xCloud. You've seen new services like Game Pass. So we're always thinking about what we can do to really grow gaming and grow the experience for our fans, but we're open to ideas. If there's things that people feel like we haven't done yet, we'd love to hear about it.
And you recently, not very recent, but All Access is in pilot, right? You're testing it out.
Yeah.
How is it going? Do you plan to expand it?
It's gone very well, exceeded our expectations, and it's been really interesting because we did want to sort of get a sense of, hey, at this point where we are, you know, a lot of people that are buying Xbox One consoles today, it's like their first console or they're new to Xbox. So how do we create a great value for them, including, you know, Game Pass, you have like 100 games plus the new releases, putting Xbox Live Gold in and the Xbox. So it's basically everything you want for one low monthly price. We've been testing it in the Microsoft stores in the US first. We had it running. We've taken that learning and now we're gonna do some more tests. So I'd say, but the feedback's been good. The response has been really good. In particular, we've seen a lot of people wanting to upgrade to the Xbox One X because of the great value that presents. And just making, you know, console gaming more affordable for more people. Obviously Brazil, with the cost of games and the cost of consoles here, this would be an ideal market, but you know, it takes time to roll this stuff out and work with partners, but we definitely want to bring it wherever it makes sense.
And talking about our market, the Xbox 360 is still the most popular console here. How are you doing to convert like this players to upgrade to the Xbox One?
Well, we feel like the Xbox One S is a great value. We're continuing to invest in more games, but I think, you know, the big thing really for folks is not only do you get the backward compatibility with your 360 games, but you get Xbox Game Pass for 29 reals a month. You get over 100 games. A lot of people were saying, for example, with Forza Horizon 4 launching, it's included in Game Pass, you know, and I've had people thank me because they were like, I couldn't afford to buy the game. I wanted to play it and it's in Game Pass. So thank you. And we've done that with Sea of Thieves and State of Decay, Crackdown, Ori, you know, Gears, whatever, you know, we're bringing will be in Game Pass the day that it launches. And that's our commitment to deliver, you know, on the value for our fans.
And the Xbox One X is almost at its 1 year anniversary in less than a month, right?
Yes. November last year. Yeah.
And how is it the reception being for players and developers as well?
Good. I mean, you know, this was a big focus, I think, for Phil and the leadership team was, you know, Xbox has always been known for having the most powerful hardware, something our fans were really vocal about. I think the team did incredible work, you know, essentially to deliver a whole new console, 40% more powerful than anything exists. And we're seeing all the big third-party games, whatever game you like to play, it's going to look and play best on the Xbox One X. We also rolled out a lot of new development tools to make development a lot easier for our development partners as well. So I think the team, you know, it was a really successful launch, and the fans' feedback has been great. I love my Xbox One X. I am amazed at the visual quality that it gives me. But I also use mine. I watch TV. I have all my apps, YouTube, you know, Netflix, etc. So it's a pretty capable box, and I think fans have responded well.
And we're all talking about, like, the next generation is getting closer. How are you convincing people to buy the X now instead of waiting until a few years to the next generation of consoles?
Well, I mean, I think one of the things people are seeing right now is that we were trying to really think about with the X, while it's still just under 1 year old, is how can we innovate with hardware, you know, and kind of break the traditional console life cycle where you don't lose compatibility, but you get the benefits of upgrading. So I think backward compatibility is one example of that. And we've talked about people investing in hardware, investing in games, investing in content. People are building digital libraries now, and they want to be able to take that with them. You know, we haven't said when it would make sense to have another, you know, console, you know, and I'd say for now we feel really, really strong about the offering that we have. So, but know that what you're investing in, we're thinking about that with a look forward, so that people feel like that investment was sound.
And now talking a little bit about games, you were talking about Forza Horizon 4. It was a big success, great ratings, great sales. And the Horizon series started kind of a spin-off from the Motorsport series. And do you still see it as kind of a spin-off, or do you see it's gaining life of its own?
Well, you know, the team at Playground, Ralph Fulton, the team there, are really incredibly talented. And I remember when they showed us their first vision video for the original Forza Horizon, they're like, we kind of want, like, we love Forza Motorsport, and like, we want to get off track, off road, and we want to, like, take that and combine it with, like, the music festival lifestyle. And they did it, you know, and then they keep bringing more innovation. And we thought, man, after Australia and what they did with Forza Horizon 3, how are they going to keep innovating? But, you know, bringing it to beautiful historic Britain, that's where they're based, so to be able to build it in their home country and to integrate all the seasons. Seasons are changing every week, every Thursday, which the whole gameplay changes. And of course, there's events and new cars launching. So it's just incredible what they've done. It's a hard game to put down. It just keeps you wanting to play just a little bit more. And it's just incredible to see the innovation. And I'd say it's a main, big part of the Forza franchise. It's as big as Forza Motorsport is for us. And we're looking to continue to grow and bring more fans into the Forza franchise.
And talking about Playground, it's known that they are working an open world RPG, and rumor says it's a new Fable. Can you tell us anything about it?
Well, what I can tell you is the facts, which are that it's awesome, by the way, this industry, because people are so passionate, so much speculation. And by the way, we're gamers too, so like, we love all the same things you do, we read the same forums, we listen, and so just know that, like, when you go and make a game and you build a team, you know, you really want to give that team, like, all the creative freedom to go realize their vision. And we're giving them the resources to go do that. They have a fully dedicated team that they're going to go make something else. We haven't said what that is. And when they're ready and they feel like it's ready to share, we will. It's interesting to see all the rumors. You know, and I'll just say in the industry, hey, sometimes rumors are wrong, sometimes they're right. We generally don't confirm them, but it's just interesting to see the speculation. What I can say is that team, every game they've made that we've worked with them on, has been extremely high quality, extremely high rated. It's the same team and management that's overseeing the second studio, so I have high confidence they're going to make something really, really special. And you're right, they have a lot of good experience in the open world game space.
And what about the other studios that you announced being part of Microsoft's Ninja Theory? I have the names here, Initiative, Undead Labs, and Compulsion Games. When are we going to hear about them?
Yeah, I mean, we unveiled sort of a dream team of creative development studios at E3. They're all in different cycles and timing. I mean, Compulsion just launched We Happy Few. They'll be bringing more content for that. Undead, you know, had the big hit this autumn here in Brazil with State of Decay 2. And they're adding more content as well. That community continues to grow. The Initiative is a brand new studio. I was just talking to Daryl Gallagher, actually. I had a call with him from here in Brazil, and they're hiring and they're growing and they're doing a lot of the foundational work. And then we talked about Playground. So they're all kind of in different, and then Ninja Theory. I'm going out to Ninja Theory in another week. So if they're all in different, I think I just spit on your microphone. They're all, sorry, it's been a long day. No offense to Brazil, but anyway, so Yeah, they're an incredibly creative team. So I just say, when we're ready, we'll reveal it. We have a lot of surprises planned for our fans. And with that said, we're also planning on growing our first party studios more. As Phil said, that was one big commitment, but we're continuing to invest in content. So you'll be seeing more from us in that space.
And about Brazil, you have you invest a lot in our market, our community. How do you plan to tight this relationship even further?
Yeah, I mean, Brazil has been so great to Xbox, you know, from the early Xbox 360 days. We're really grateful for that support. It's also, you know, for us as a region, Latin America, South America is our fastest growing region in the world. Brazil is the biggest market here. And Game Pass specifically, Brazil is now one of our very fastest growing markets in the world for Game Pass. So it's just good to see. I mean, as you know, we're launching our first party games day and date in Brazil. We're localizing them in Portuguese. You know, this is a top priority market for us. And I think you've seen that. You know, we have the Xbox One X here now. We'll be bringing more services, more content here when they're available. And the fans, holy cow, man, the fans here are passionate. They love gaming, so it's just great to see and know that we're listening. And if they have feedback for us and what they want us to do in Brazil, we'd love to hear it.
You had the Fun Fest yesterday, right? And I saw a couple got married in it.
Yes, we did Fan Fest with, you know, a few hundred of our biggest, most passionate fans. But there was two fans that had told us that they were going to move their wedding so they could come to FanFest. They wanted to meet Rod Ferguson. They're big, big Gears of War fans. But they were planning to get married at the same time. And the team said, well, what if we could do your wedding at FanFest? And they were like, wow, that would be our dream. So, you know, they had a special Xbox Gears of War cake. They cut the cake with the Lancer. It was amazing. It was actually a really beautiful wedding and really special. So we wanted to make sure that they had their special moment and let them do their traditional wedding. And then at the end, Rod and I came out and gave them a couple nice gifts. But it's amazing. I mean, only in Brazil would you do a Gears of War wedding. Something I've never seen before.
That was nice of you. I had no idea, like, you had helped them plan everything. So that's really nice.
Yeah, I think, you know, yes. If you're looking to get married at Xbox, hopefully you see that we do a nice service. And if you've met somebody in gaming and want to make a long-term commitment, you never know what can happen. I mean, really, the power of gaming that has on people's lives, that's the thing that just blows me away. People that are falling in love, that are playing games, it's such a great unifier, and this is just one great example of that.
Maybe that can be the next Xbox service.
That's right, Xbox weddings.
Yes.
There we go, yes.
Now talking about Microsoft as a whole, like Xbox as a whole, what can we expect for the next few years?
Well, you're just going to see incredible innovation and investment in gaming because we're growing our content. You know, we have over 3,000 games today available on Xbox One. We just doubled our creative studios. We're going to be adding more there. I think we have the best in class, you know, third-party partnerships, all those games looking and playing best on our system. Innovating with Xbox Game Pass, things like All Access is another example. And then I think, you know, the Project X Cloud is really exciting. As you think about the future of gaming, being able to play those types of games on your phone, on your tablet, no matter where you are. And so gaming is growing. I mean, it's growing for us. It's growing for what people would think of as our competitors. It's growing for all of the publishers. So it's just as an entertainment form, it's a great time to see just gaming flourishing and doing so well. And we're going to continue to support that for our fans.
Anything else you want to say to Brazilian fans to wrap up this interview? Something you hadn't had the chance to say yet?
I'll just say, muito obrigado. Thank you for all your incredible support, your passion. Brazil, there is nothing like this country and the passion for gaming. I can't even walk to the bathroom without getting stopped. But it's amazing because you can see it in people's eyes, how much they love gaming and whatever their favorite franchise is. So I just want to say thank you. Because we work really hard, but we do it for you. And hopefully we're meeting your standard and know that we're continuing to listen and we wanna continue to bring great games to Brazil.
Thank you very much. É isso aí, pessoal. Essa foi a entrevista com Aaron Greenberg, do Xbox.